October favorites for you, and it's not many, but still I made some new friendships with a couple of products and I want to share that with you. And let's get started with the new It brushes by Ulta. They are fantastic. I mean, really, I've normally used a Real Techniques blending brush, but this one here, the blending brush from It Cosmetics, so much better, so soft. Like, I feel the Real Techniques always skipped a little bit on me, cause you know, it's not their youngest skin anymore up here. And really, really loving this blending brush. It's fluffy, it's super soft. Love it, it's awesome. And I also have this little airbrush precision smudger, and really loving that one too. Great for some detail work. I like to smudge out under my waterline a little bit, and then for a tiny little V, especially if you have hooded eyes like me, a tiny brush like that is awesome. So I'm loving these brushes, and I'm very happy that It Cosmetics came out with an, you know, affordable brush line at Ulta. So they were like, I think $14 and $12, so you cannot complain about that. I'm loving them, and I think I might want to get some cheek, bigger brushes from It Cosmetics by Ulta. And I'm loving another Tarte Lip Surgeon's Power Pigment Intense in Exposed. Really love these Tarte lip crayons. It's so easy, you know, to work it more correctly on than a lipstick. So I like the fine tip, and it's a hint of peppermint. It's fresh. I have it on. It's a nude color, and really, really loving that one. And I think I need a whole collection of these Tarte lip crayons. Love them. And then I'm really loving this new little gem I got from Hard Candy. And I saw that on Kathy A's channel, she got that. And you know, usually all the Hard Candy products, they're very glittery, very girly. Like, seems too young for me when I look at this stuff. It's not appealing. But this little palette here, I mean, I think the design is really pretty too. It has only matte colors, and I really like the color range, very appropriate for fall. And I have it on right now, and I love this rusty color here. It's really like rust, and also like, you know, the lighter colors for on the lid. And here's a nice blue color, very, very deep, and but yet settled, you know, not like crazy pop colors. It's very settled, very age appropriate. So I'm really, really loving these. You know, some of these colors are a little bit patchy, but the thing is, this thing costs $6. I mean, it looks so elegant, has nice color range, all matte for $6. I mean, I'm impressed. Love it. And then I'm loving my NYX Wonder Pencil. I was looking for a cruelty-free nude pencil for my waterline. And because I use the Rimmel Scandal Eyes in nude, most of us do. And I must say, this one compares to it. And color-wise, there's no, you know, no payoff, but no payoff. Color-wise, they really are identical. And I have the, I think that is the lightest shade, because the cool thing is, yeah, light. They have it in three colors from NYX. So maybe you are a little bit more dark-skinned, and then this might look harsh on you. And I might admit, the Rimmel Scandal Eyes is much softer, so it applies way easier. This one is a little harder, but therefore I had always problems sharpening the Rimmel one because it's so soft, and then the black pencil is so hard. So I was putting it in a freezer for 10 minutes so I was able to sharpen it. And this one I have no problems with sharpening, and so I get a finer tip. And I have no problem that it's a little harder, because on me lots of products smudge on my eyes, and when a product is not so soft, not so buttery, it holds up longer. So I was wearing for a whole day on one eye the Rimmel Scandal Eyes and on one eye the NYX Wonder Pencil, and after a couple hours wanted to compare which one holds longer, and there was no difference. So I'm very happy I found a cruelty-free alternative to the Rimmel Scandal Eyes. And I'm really loving my Tarte Blush in Exposed, which is almost like a bronzy color, and I wear it also. So almost just like a bronzer, yet better, more glowy and very natural. And I always feel like it looks like I was just taking a walk at the beach and have, you know, this first little sun on my cheeks. So it's very natural, very subtle, but I love it, love it. And I'm loving my little facial pad. I made a little video about that. You can check that out. This is so fun to get your face clean with it. It's massaging nicely, and I just feel very clean with it. I'm very happy about that. Best $6 you can invest, in my opinion. And last but not least, I love the Method Summer Collection. So this is a limited edition, and you might not be able to get it anymore. This is in vanilla, and the vanilla is not a fake vanilla, not too crazy. It is a nice, beautiful vanilla, exactly like if you ever have tried the perfume oil from the Body Shop in vanilla, exactly like that. Just so inexpensive for $4.99, and I just saw they have a couple at Marshall's, so really you should snap these up if you're able to find them. It is beautiful, gorgeous, it smells wonderful, wonderful vanilla. And I wanted today also show a book, but it is more for my German watchers, because I know I have a couple subscribers who talk German, and this was an awesome book my mom sent me, Verbrechen von Ferdinand von Schirach. So I'm not talking too much about it, because most of you won't be able to read it, but this is a must read. Loved it so much that I right away got me the other book from him too, which is Schuld. So if you're in Germany or you talk German, you should get that book. And also I have two movies I watched which I really thought were outstanding. And that one movie was Gone Girl. Gosh, this is a psychotic thriller, super crazy. Like, if you're not into that kind of thriller stuff, you know, really crazy, then you might want to skip this one. But I was like, wow, that movie is crazy. There's just this one scene which went overboard, too much blood. I really closed my eyes when I was in the movie theater. But the movie is a must-see. Love it. And the other movie we watched is a completely different kind of type, but I really think it was worth watching too. It's more a family-oriented movie. So the movie's name is a tongue breaker. It's Alexander and the Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Very Bad Day. Now repeat that. I mean, who can? That is a stupid title, but it's really a nice, funny movie. If you have kids, you should go and watch that. But even without kids, it's a fun, fun comedy. So you should go ahead and watch that. And that sums it up. That was all my favorites. Oh, and I had this Fail the Smashbox Masterclass 3. Disliked it. You can watch my video why. This is a horrible palette, and I unfortunately still haven't gotten my money back even though I sent it back to Sephora 5 weeks ago. Let's see about that. Alright, you guys, see you next time. Bye, auf Wiedersehen.